There were pearls of sweat on her forehead. She had had a brisk walk through the village. And now she wanted to place an extraordinary order at the toy maker's. A puppet was required. A boy puppet, as big as her son, who would be turning 7, and who wanted something unusual for his birthday, something that no other child had. The puppet should be able to move its arms and legs, blink its eyes, and open its mouth, as though it could actually talk. Oh, Countess, nothing would give me more pleasure. When is your noble son's birthday, may I ask? Tomorrow. Tomorrow? With all due respect, I can't possibly produce such an unusual puppet as you've described in a day. Oh, really? Well, that's a shame. I'll just have to ask another carpenter then. The Countess turned on her heel and was just about to leave the store when Geppetto realized that he couldn't afford to miss out on a sale that would earn him at least 4 gold coins. 4 gold coins? You'll get 2, snapped the Countess. It's a big, difficult job, and I consider it to be worth 4 gold coins. But if you absolutely cannot pay more, Countess, could we at least agree on 3? She looked Geppetto in the eye, thought for a moment, smacked her lips, and calculated quietly to herself. It's extortionate, but we'll agree on 3 gold coins. But then it must be ready early tomorrow morning, at the same time as today. I'll have to put aside everything else and work all night.
Yes, so do that then,
she interrupted him and left the store. Geppetto hurried back to his workshop, chewed on the last of the bread, drank up the milk dregs, swept away the previous day's sawdust, sharpened his best wood carving knife, and got to work. Right, little cuckoo, you'd better help me keep an eye on the time so I don't lose track, because I'm going to crack on with my carpentry. We'd have to see whether these few lousy hours are enough to complete the young gentleman's birthday present.